Welcome to Wellington, cultural capital, movie capital, craft beer capital, and capital capital. People flock to Wellington from all over the place, and in the evening, they flock right back again. Things like logs and containers flock here too, although presumably not for the culture or the beer. All of this coming and going puts pressure on Wellington's vital rail services. Last year, Wellingtonians and visitors made over 14 million journeys on the Metro Rail network. That's 800,000 more than a year before. The system is coping, but it's becoming a bit of a squeeze. Fortunately, the government has earmarked $500 million to future-proof Wellington's rail network. To make it happen, Kiwi Rail and Metlink have got together on it. It's called futurerail. It will mean that our rail network is not only more reliable, but there'll be more capacity for more trains to carry more people and stuff. In fact, with the new infrastructure in place, Wellington's in the box seat to get funding for more trains, taking the pressure off our roads and reducing our carbon footprint. So how does futurerail plan to get there? For a start, the overhead lines that power our trains are aging and need to be replaced with new ones in Wellington, the Hutt Valley and Johnsonville. The 2.7 kilometre section between Trentham and Upper Hutt will be double-tracked, increasing capacity and reliability on the Wellington to the Hutt and Wairarapa lines. Meanwhile, Plimmerton is being made into a proper terminus station. All over the region, tracks, tunnels and bridges are being upgraded and slopes stabilised. Will you notice all this going on? Probably. It's hard to work on the tracks when there's a train on them, so some services will take a break and be replaced by buses at off-peak times and public holidays. While there'll be plenty of construction around the place, we'll do our best to make sure you don't have to deal with too much noise or disruption. When it's over, we'll have a rail system that can handle more trains, more people, and more freight. And that's going to set Wellington up as the sustainable, people-centred growth capital. If you'd like to know more about this, visit the Metlink website here.